Hello students, yes, myself Narayan Sore. Today we'll discuss that is muscular tissue. Okay, in previous session we discussed epithelial tissue, connective tissue. Now it is the third type of animal tissue, that is the muscular tissue. And muscular tissue are mainly related with the our movements of the body. Okay, are mainly it is related to the movements of the parts of the body, and also along with that, yes, it means having again some type, that is we could have first one is the voluntary muscles, second one is the involuntary muscles, and third one is the cardiac muscle. Okay, suppose take example of that is contraction of hands and relaxation of hands. Okay, that continuous that opening and closing of our eyelids. Okay, take example, best example of our live movement, that is the heart, that is rhythmically contract and relax continuously. When we take food inside our body, yes, it enters into the esophagus, then there is a contraction, and again the food is not present in that tube, that is the relaxation. And yes, means contraction and relaxation, that with the help of peristaltic movement, yes, that food enters into the stomach, and yes, it is carried forward towards the that total alimentary canal. So likewise, all the things, yes, it is related with the movement. Movement means, yes, it is the function of, yes, this is the function of muscular tissue. Yes, so in this muscular tissue, suppose I categorize here mainly voluntary tissues, involuntary tissues, and the cardiac tissue or the muscles, or voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles, and the cardiac muscles. So see, yes, in voluntary muscles, mainly this group of cells are cylindrical. Yes, how the shape is? Yes, it is cylindrical. Okay, and also they are unbranched. Okay, they are unbranched. Again, see here, yes, on these voluntary muscles, that striations are present. Striations in the sense, this is suppose take example here. This is the dark band, okay. Then, this one is again dark band. This one is the dark, and this one is the light. So, like these striations are present over all that muscle, so that we call as the means with the striations. Okay, then see involuntary muscles. Okay, they are spindle shaped. They are spindle shaped, but they lack the striations. They lack the striations. Okay, so these striations are not present on the involuntary muscles. Okay, and see here, what about the that in cells or the group of cells, they have the nucleus. But these nucleus are not only single; it is many, more than one. So these cells or these tissues are called as the multinucleated. Yes, it is called as the multinucleated. But in involuntary, yes, only the single nucleus is present. So that's why it is uninucleated. Okay. Yes, it is a uninucleated. Okay. So now see here, cardiac muscles. Yes, the shape. Yes, of that cell, that is the cylindrical. Yes, they are branched, and also it is they are the uninucleated. Now this voluntary muscles, where it is present in our body? It is present in the body wall. Yes, it is present in our limbs. It is present in tongue. It is present in the pharynx. Also it is present initial part of the esophagus. Okay, it is present at the, yes, initial part of the esophagus. Then see involuntary muscles, where it is present? It is present in the iris of the eye. Yes, iris, it is the colored part, yes, of our eye. These are the points of our, that is the iris of eye. Then yes, it is present in ureter. Okay, ureter means that we discuss in excretory system, that pair of ureters connected with the respective kidneys, and yes, which taking that urine into the urinary bladder after filtration. Then this is, it is present in the bronchi of lungs. It is present in the bronchi of lung. But most characteristic feature of voluntary and involuntary, why suppose these muscles are called as voluntary and why these muscles are called as involuntary? So answer is that the movement of the body, or suppose take example of limb, when it is in our wheel, yes, it is in our wheel. Suppose take I will up down. Okay, it is in our wheel. Okay, so such muscle movement or such muscles are called as voluntary muscles. Okay, yes, such muscles are called as the voluntary muscles. So striation present, then it is also called as the striated muscle. It is also called as the striated muscle. Okay, but in horizontally means
the movement, yes, that body movement, it is not in our brain. Yes,
so such muscles movement, yes, it is called as involuntary muscles.
Yes, which is called as
involuntary muscle. Okay, now see here the cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle present exclusively only in the heart. Okay, it is present only in the heart. Okay, and yes, what is the function of this heart? We know that. Yes, it works rapidly, rhythmically, tirelessly, continuously from our embryonic stage, yes, until death. Okay, it is continuously working. Okay, so these are the voluntary, involuntary, and cardiac muscles. So see here diagram, that is striated muscles showing the striations, these smooth muscles which are spindle shape. Okay, and these cardiac muscles, yes, showing in this format. So yes, this is for today's session. If you like this session, please like, subscribe, and share.